Hi everyone, my name is Maxime Mouchet and I'm going to present you how to integrate Julia in JavaScript using Node.js extensions. So let's say that you have some algorithm written in Julia and that you want to use this algorithm from another application and for example a Node.js application. Typically to exchange data between your application and your algorithm, you can for example use HTTP by building an HTTP API around your algorithm. Or you can also use the standard input-output of your terminal. Another way that I'm going to present you is to directly integrate the Julia algorithm inside the Node.js application and to exchange data by sharing memory between the runtimes. As we will see, this has some performance advantages and it also avoids the need to install Julia on the server where you will potentially deploy your application. So the goal is to have some code written in Julia. For example, here we have the kmeans function from the clustering.jl package, which performs the kmeans clustering of a dataset, and to be able to call this function from a Node.js application written in JavaScript. To achieve that, there are three steps. The first step is to build a system image with package compiler.jl. The second step is to interface the Julia and Node runtimes with the Node extension API. And the first step is to distribute the extension so that you can install it later using the Node Package Manager. I'm going to show you an overview of these three steps, but I put a full example on GitHub where I detail all of these three steps. So the first step is to build a system image with package compiler.jl. I'm not going to go much into the details because package compiler is a well-known Julia package, but the main idea is that package compiler will take your Julia source code and compile it into a system image, including all the Julia libraries needed at runtime. The second step is to interface the Julia and Node runtimes. So to do that, you need to write a Node.js extension, typically in C or C++, and the main goal of this extension is to call the Julia function and return the result to Node.js, and also to convert between Node.js types and Julia types. To write this extension, you can use different APIs. You can use directly the JavaScript Virtual Machine API, in this case the V8 API, which is written in C++, but this is not recommended since this API is not stable across Node versions. So a better choice is the Node extension API, the NAPI, which is written in C, or the C++ wrapper of NAPI, which is called Node Add-on API. And I'm going to show you some code using Node Add-on API. So basically, to write your extension, all you need to do is to define a C++ function, which will take as an input the arguments from the JavaScript side, convert those arguments to Julia values, call the Julia function with those values, and then convert back the results to JavaScript values. One interesting thing that you can do in this extension is that you can share memory between the Node.js application and the Julia algorithm. But you need to pay attention to the ownership of the memory. If you are giving to your Julia algorithm some memory owned by Node.js, there is no problem because the Node garbage collector will know that the memory is will not free the memory while it is used by the Julia algorithm. On the other hand, if your Julia algorithm is returning a pointer to some memory it has allocated, for example, an array, a vector, a matrix, and so on, you need to copy the data before returning it to the Node.js runtime because the Julia garbage collector has no knowledge of the Node.js application and it may free the memory at any point in time. Another interesting thing that you can do is that you can catch Julia exception in your extension and throw these exceptions as Node.js exceptions. So you can directly catch the Julia exceptions in your Node.js JavaScript code. So this is very useful for debugging. Finally, once you've written your extension, you need to to distribute the extension so that you can install it on your server with or where you want to deploy your application. You can install it with the Node Package Manager without needing to compile anything on the target machine or to install Julia on target machine. So one nice tool to do that is the Node Pre-Gip tool from Mapbox, which handles the build of your application, so of your extension, sorry. So it will take the C, C++ source code and build the binary of your extension, which is a shared library. And it will also create a package, an archive of your extension, including the Julia system image and Julia libraries, and push this archive to Amazon S3. So later, when you will do npm install of your package, it's going to fetch automatically the archive with your binaries from Amazon S3. So as I've said before, I've put an example API, an example extension on GitHub, which is a Node.js Express API that expose the kmeans function from the clustering.jl package, and it includes everything from building the system image to building the extension and packaging the extension and so on. So feel free to have a look for a complete overview. One limitation of this approach is the concurrency. I didn't manage to run several instances of a Julia algorithm in parallel. If I use Julia thread, there is a crash with a segmentation fault, and all we have the same with JavaScript worker thread. So maybe it's possible to use Julia thread or JavaScript worker thread with this method, but it requires more research, I think, to make that work. On the other hand, if you want to have several instances of your algorithm in parallel, you can run separate node processes and there will be no problem. Everything will work as expected. Finally, the advantages of this approach is that you can share memory between the Julia and Node.js runtimes. So if you need to send a lot of data from Node.js to your Julia application, this is going to be very efficient. You can catch Julia exceptions in JavaScript, which is useful for debugging. You can distribute your extension with the Node Package Manager, and you don't need to deploy Julia on the server, and there will be no compilation cost at the runtime. On the other hand, this is more complicated, for example, than writing a simple Julia HTTP API. And the binaries that you build, they are platform dependent. So if you build your extension on macOS, it's going to work only on macOS. The main resources that you can use to build an extension, they are the Node NAPI documentation and the embedding Julia documentation. But as I've said previously, I've also put a repository on GitHub with an example extension and links to much more resources on how to build an extension, and that you can also use if you want to build native extensions for other languages or and other runtimes than Node.js. Thank you.